to you by Penguin.
Help, I Sexted My Boss by William Hanson and Jordan North.
Read by William Hanson and Jordan North.
To G and Divas.
Past, present and future.
Introduction.
Picture the scene. You're casually standing at a luxury party with a friend, sipping a glass of something fizzy, when all of a sudden, a wide-eyed individual comes bounding up to you, smiling as if they've just won the lottery.
Darling, they squeal enthusiastically. It's been so long. How are you? I've been meaning to get in touch. As they witter on, it dawns on you that, while the face may be familiar, the person's name is nowhere near the tip of your tongue.
As you respond with an over-the-top, "Oh, wow, it's so good to see you too," your brain works overtime to spot any clues that might help you work out who the hell this person is before you try to find an ingenious way of introducing them to your friend. But then, before you know it, that moment you've been dreading arrives. Expectant eyes fall on you as the newcomer awaits their introduction. You feel your heart beat a little faster and your cheeks flush. But no matter how deep you root around in your brain, a name is not forthcoming, and you want nothing more than to simply melt into the ground.
Does this sound familiar? Well, of course it does. It happens to us all, so you really don't need to beat yourself up about it. But in the heat of the moment, it's easy to feel like the rudest person to ever have walked on Earth. Yes, you may have met this person for 5 minutes 18 months ago, which makes it forgivable and understandable that you don't remember their name, but the notion of leaving someone feeling crushed that they haven't quite made the impact on you they may have desired is sometimes hard to bear.
As happy-go-lucky as life can be, there are times when we can find ourselves in embarrassing situations where we desperately want the world to open up and swallow us whole. This is where etiquette can come in and save us all. By definition, etiquette is a set of courteous rules based on societal norms. While you might think etiquette is a practice from yesteryear, when men wore pantaloons and women were trussed up in tight corsets in lavish courts, you'd be wrong. We still abide by rules of etiquette, and they still help the world to run smoothly. But things do change as the world evolves.
While there have been many books written about etiquette over the years, a lot of them are formal, rooted in history, which are not really relevant to life in the 21st century, which is where our rather fabulous tome comes in. This book is different from the rest because it has been written by two best friends who come from very different sides of the tracks, and here our tracks shall divide, so allow us to introduce ourselves.
You have William Hanson, the UK's leading etiquette expert.
And Jordan North, the radio and television presenter who very nearly won the 2020 series of ITV's I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, after conquering his fear of snakes, heights and working a full 5 day week.
I work very hard, I love you know. Together, William and I host a podcast called Help I Sexted My Boss, in which we offer advice to help navigate the challenges of modern life. In this book, we've pulled all our wisdom together to create our definitive guide.
But why, I hear you ask? When I was a young lad growing up in Bristol, my grandmother, Etiquette Granny, gifted me a book about etiquette that I devoured in one sitting. Inspired by its teachings, I read more and more books on the subject and began to lead my life based on what I had learned. Renowned for my fledgling expertise, I was asked by teachers at my school to instruct the younger pupils on how to set a table, a role that caught the eye of the local press and titles such as The Prestigious Tattler. After school, I was approached to join the English Manor, a very well-respected etiquette training institute, and this saw me sent round the world on napkin-related business, as well as invited onto a variety of television programmes and radio stations to talk about all manner of topics, from tipping and queuing to greeting royalty. And that was how I met my Sexted sidekick.
I was a runner at a radio station in Manchester when I met William for the first time back in 2011. We were chalk and cheese. He was dead posh and used all these big words. And from the look of him in his sensible jumper, I reckoned he was a 40-year-old fellow who spent his nights at home sipping sherry with his librarian wife. I guess I'm not good at first impressions. As it turned out, we were both 21 at the time, and William didn't and never would have a wife. I, on the other hand, was from a working-class family from Burnley and loved going out and drinking Guinness. I still do. I had a proper northern upbringing with my dad Graham and my mum Wendy, who ultimately helped shape my outlook on life, which is very different to William's.
Our friendship blossomed, and when we started our podcast in 2018, we had no idea it would be so popular.
For the first few months, it was just our friends and family who listened. But over time, more and more people told their mates, and the audience grew and grew.
Sexted wouldn't be what it is today if it weren't for our listeners, who we affectionately refer to as G and Divas, and their willingness to share their dilemmas. Because you're listening to this audiobook, you're now officially a G and Diva too, so welcome to the gang.
That nickname comes from the drink William and I fill our glasses with at the start of each podcast episode. Gin and a bonnet.
For the uninitiated, gin and a bonnet is a refreshingly fruity drink with a slightly bitter edge that was the favourite drink of both late Queens Elizabeth. If you want to sip one, responsibly, of course, because it is very strong, while listening along, and we very much hope you do, please do.
William and Jordan's perfect G&D recipe.
One part gin, a regular gin, not a newfangled flavoured one. Two parts to bonnet. Ice cubes, not crushed ice. Citrus peel, orange if you have a sweet tooth, lemon if you prefer a more bitter flavour. Add the ingredients into a low-ball tumbler with a heavy bottom and a delicate rim. Stir. Enjoy. What has helped Jordan and I become accomplished agony aunts are the varied letters, emails and messages we have received from our G&D Divas over the years.
Most touch on dating and relationship dilemmas, family fallouts and work-related dramas, but from time to time, we hear about some outrageous stuff, like the guy who seduced his boyfriend's cousin while wearing a Spider-Man costume.
We can safely say we have heard it all. It's these many stories that have helped shape the writing of this book.
Don't forget the couple who were left speechless when they found a poo-filled condom in their mate's freezer.
Apparently this practice is known as igluing, and it will be forever tattooed on my mind.
Mine too.
In this book, we won't be concentrating, as I do in my day job as an etiquette coach, and yes, that is an actual job despite what HMRC tell me, on how to behave at Buckingham Palace or what to do at Ascot. This is an essential handbook for those of you who perhaps have to worry less about how to address a bishop during Lent and are more concerned about what to do if you catch your flatmate enjoying themselves in the kitchen.
Yes, this isn't for Lord and Lady Uppercrust. It's for people like you and me, the Dukes and Duchess of Wetherspoons.
If you have a more refined mind, I will also be sharing useful things like how to set the perfect dinner table, explaining what you should and shouldn't wear to the office, and some little bits of history that you can impress your friends with. These titbits are affectionately referred to as my etiquettemologies. We'll be laying down our golden rules, but also responding to real-life dilemmas from our dear G&D Divas. But before we proceed, let me make clear that neither Jordan nor I are qualified experts in offering life advice. We're not therapists, counsellors, or anything remotely resembling such esteemed roles, so don't take anything we say too seriously. But in these chapters, we will be offering you our very humble advice on a range of everyday dilemmas, from house shares to house parties, and from nights out to working out.
Right, everyone's up to speed. It's time to grab your gin and bonnet and get stuck in. We really hope you enjoy listening to this audiobook as much as we have enjoyed writing it.
William.
And Jordan. I can't believe we're doing this.
Yeah, it's fun.
We're doing a book.
Finding love.
William's more, be still my beating heart.
Jordan's more, shut up, you tart.
Until you find the one, the long winding road to love is never easy. It's full of U-turns, dead ends, and the odd pothole. As the listeners of our podcast have told us over the years, many of the letters and emails we get relate to the world of dating. People want to know the answers to the big questions, like how should they style their dating profiles, where's good and where's bad for the high-stakes first date, and how they can smoothly and courteously take things to the next level. We'll start the audiobook by offering our thoughts on this most tricky of topics.
As the great romantic novels and cinematic masterpieces of the past have taught us, finding that special someone is for many the end goal, one that will ultimately bring eternal happiness.
Or even a bit of fun along the way.
Yeah, well, maybe. But with so many people looking for Mr., Ms. or Mix right, navigating the choppy waters of the dating ocean in this hectic day and age is far from easy, especially when so many sharks are lurking beneath the surface, ready to gobble them up. In fact, even though there are so many ways of finding a potential soulmate, it seems to be harder than ever to meet someone, as there are so many other ravenous fish in the sea, all looking for that special someone to fall for hook, line, and sinker.
Oh, I'm living for your fishy puns, William.
Good.
Your piranha roll. That was good for me. We all want to find that person who is shrimply the best.
Start the car.
You know, that fantastic partner who will make you stop and think to yourself, oh my God, I want to reel them in, date them and make it official.
Jordan, enough of the fish puns, please.
You started it.
Yes, and now I'm finishing it. Right, let's get back to what we do best.
What, getting pissed on Gin and the Bonnie?
Well, yes, but also...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.